So yesterday we were talking about the three major type of transducers, modifiers, the input and output energy, the same form. Input and output for self-generators, input and output and, energy, different form. And for modulators, we are dealing with modulating signals. So relatively small modulating signals modulates the flow of energy between input and output. And we discuss some examples. We discuss the issue that self-generating transducers usually produce the very low level of output energy, having a low effective conversion efficiency. So thermocouple based on Peltier effect, yeah, Peltier effect, Seebeck effect, of course, Seebeck effect is an example of self-exciting or self-generating transducer. Modulating, they require such a source of energy. Photoconductive cells, thermistors, they are examples of modulating. Relatively large flow of electrical energy is controlled by much smaller input signal energy. And modifying transducers, we discuss elastic beams, diaphragms, and also cantilever as an example of modifying transducer. Modifying transducer for mechanical quantities works like some sort of mechanical transformer, because when we discuss this transduction chain for membrane or for cantilever, where the input signal was causing mechanical deflection, later causing stress change, and if the piezo-resistive element was diffused or implanted into the membrane, into elastic element, it was causing the change of resistance. So transfer characteristic, output-input relationship was the, in the case of a pressure sensor discussed yesterday, was a pressure versus, sorry, resistance versus pressure. And here, mechanical transformer, small energy was causing relatively large electrical output signal. Now, Middlehook proposed this three-dimensional representation of all existing transducers, existing and still non-existing, because when Middlehook proposed this representation several years ago, several quantities were still not sensed. For instance, in early 80s, this nice representation did not include sensor for aroma and for taste. And people were saying, oh, it is impossible to sense taste and aroma. And of course, these gaps were filled, because nowadays we have electronic noses, which are commercialized, widely used by industry. And we have also electronic tongues. You can assess, for instance, the quality of mineral water using electronic tongue. So we have a three axis, input energy, output energy, Z modulating signal, and the six, the most important forms of energy. Most important form of energy. So, in the XY plane, we have a primary energy input represented x-axis and energy output y-axis. So all self-generating transducers are lying on the xy plane. With the six form of energy, we have 36 forms, 36 possibilities, from which 30 are self-generators and the rest six modifiers. As I mentioned yesterday, we are only interested in transducers with electrical output signal. So self-generators are represented by crosses in this. Self-generators with electrical output signal by crosses in this plane. The modulating transducers are represented by points in three-dimensional space. And as I mentioned, there are still some gaps, but they are filled, because this area of science is very vibrant, and people are still developing novel sensors. So the middle hook representation is very useful to understand all these sensors and transducers. Now, the most important physical effects and associated transducers are listed in this table for all existing transducers. So we have self-generators, transduction type, radiant electrical, photovoltaic. This is the solar cell. We can consider solar cell as a sensor, yeah? Because it transfers solar energy into electrical energy. So it's a sensor, according to this representation. Mechanical electrical, they are the best example, piezo transducers. So electrical output-input relationship is a resistance change versus force or any related value like pressure, acceleration, displacement, piezo effect. Thermal electrical, temperature voltage, thermocouples. Magnetic electrical, electromagnetic flux change voltage. Magnetic field sensors, for instance, based on the Hall effect, where the intensity of magnetic field could be measured by the proper arrangement of the semiconductor. The output voltage for Hall sensors, as you know, the output signal is a voltage. So the transfer characteristic is a voltage shift versus magnetic field intensity. The next group, modulators, electrical, radiant electrical, photoconductive, radiation resistant change, photoemissive, electrical, mechanical, electrical, again, piezoresistive, strain resistance, strain gauges, very important group of sensors, widely used around the world. This is millions of them are used since early 30s of the last century. First metallic piezoresistive gauges to assess the distribution of stress in many mechanical constructions. For instance, it was, you know, there is a need to continuously measure stress distribution in a bridges, because if the bridge is overloaded, it could collapse. And such a case occurred around 25 years ago in Melbourne. bridge collapsed because many trucks were passing the bridge. Stress was not measured, and as a result, catastrophe. Electrical thermoresistive, temperature resistant change. Electrical magnetic, magnetoresistive. In magnetoresistive, we have an input magnetic field intensity and the output resistance change. Again, commercially available sensors. Radiant mechanical radiant, radiation change due to the motion. So the best example, optical encoders, very powerful sensors because they can be very accurate. Very accurate. And finally, modifiers, radiant radiant. Temperature change due to the collector radiation. So thermal radiation detector. Thermal radiation detector, very powerful sensing system to assess the state of our health, because the heat distribution in our body volume is the best indication of the state of our health. Yeah? When we are healthy, we're in a full swing, completely different temperature distribution than when we are sick. Mechanical, we're not interested because there is no electrical output signal. And also when we look, or look according to this representation, which is very logical, ordinary amplifier where we have voltage as an input signal, one level of voltage, and elevated level of voltage as an output signal, this is also a sensor. Senses voltage, yeah? So here we have electrical, changing the electrical form. Amplifier, filters, bridge circuits, all of them are also sensors with electrical output signal. Now we will go to the next one. How to switch this to, because I still have to learn.